Hello everyone. So today here in front of you, we are having falling ball viscometer designed and manufactured by SciTech model 29F. On the top of this table, we are having the falling ball viscometer at an angle 10 degree. Second thing, we are having an auxiliary equipments in which we have balls and some guiding tools. We have stopwatch, one measuring or weighing scale, beakers with water, sugar for making the sugar solution, and some samples. So first we will start with about the introduction of the falling ball viscometer. The falling ball viscometer is based on the measuring principle of Hofmeyer principle, and it is very precise for measuring the dynamic viscosity of the Newtonian fluids. Now, Newtonian fluids are what? Newtonian fluids is a fluid in which viscous thing arising from its flow at every point are linearly to the load strain rate at the rate of change of its deformation over time. It is some kind of a mechanical language, but in a simple layman language we will see that in this instrument, as you can see, one glass container is there. This glass container we can rotate at an 180 degree from top to bottom around this bevel screw. Here we are having one outer glass and the inner glass. The inner glass is containing your Newtonian fluids. Basically, simply at the experiment, what we have to do, that we are having some metal and glass balls. So this metal and glass balls is having some ball constants and the diameters and some weights. We have to fill the Newtonian fluid inside this glass tube, and we have to put the ball from top. After that, just turn it around at an angle and measure the time, how much time it will take to fall with the help of the gravity at an angle of 10 degree until the bottom part. For calculating the time, we are having a stopwatch. So with the help of this stopwatch, we can calculate how much amount of time it will take from top to bottom for that balls come. With the help of this thing, according to the formula of the dynamic viscosity, density of the fluid we have known, density of the solution we can calculate, and the density of the ball, which is already given at a constant, and with the help of that thing, we can calculate the dynamic viscosity of the fluid. Now, second thing, another advantage of this thing is, after replacing this fluid, we can add another Newtonian fluid with the help of this normal screw. Just open, after opening this screw, we are having some bevel jackets inside it. After opening this bevel jackets, we have to pour the another Newtonian liquid, and we can put the another ball numbers. We have already given here total 6 number of balls. 4 to 5 are metal balls and 2 are this glass balls. Now this glass balls and metal balls is having its specific gravity and the specific known weight, which is already mentioned in the manual, and how to operate this falling ball viscometer, that we will start studying today. First we will start with the making of the solution. I am taking here sugar as a solute and water as a solvent. So what we will do today, we will make two kinds of mixture. One, that is, I am having a sample of 40% sugar solution, and another one is having a 20% sugar solution. Now for how to make this 20% and 40% sugar solution, that we will study. This is our falling ball viscometer, which is we can set at an angle of 10 degree, and we can rotate through this bevel at around 180 degree like this way. This is our bottom part of the falling ball viscometer, and this is our top part of the falling ball viscometer. This is our glass tube. Inside this glass tube, the height of this glass tube is around 300 mm, and inside this another one glass tube is there. That glass tube is containing the Newtonian fluids. Another one, that is a thermometer, is there. This glass thermometer is recording the temperature of the outer fluid outside the Newtonian fluids. We are having another two nozzles. These two nozzles will help us for providing hot water or cold water or medium, as you can say, from the thermostating expansion bath. That is a exponent, or you can say it is an extra part in which falling ball viscometer we can go for the calculation for outer diameter, or you can say outer part of the Newtonian fluids. Another one, with this we have ocular equipment, that is this black box in which we are having some balls. These are the metal balls and glass balls for performing the experiment with the falling ball viscometer. There is some arrangement, mechanical arrangement for opening and for maintenance of the falling ball viscometer. So, with the help of this spanner, we can open this glass tube, and for cleaning purpose, we have to use this spanner. We are having one stopwatch for calculation of the time. We are having a weighing scale. This weighing scale is an electronic in which we have to make how much amount of solute we have to add for making the solvent. We are having one sugar ball. This sugar, as I am today using as for the experiment medium, that is for making the sugar solution. Sugar I am using for as a solute, and normal water, distilled water I am using for the solvent. I have already done for making 40% of sugar solution and 20% of sugar solution. This sugar solution I am using as a medium to pour inside the falling ball viscometer. So, with the help of this solute and with the help of this solvent, with weighing scale, we have to make one solvent or solution, you can say, and with the help of this calculation on the paper, and we will write the data, and we will calculate first density of the solution. After calculating the density of the solution, we will pour the solution inside our falling ball viscometer, and then we will pour the ball. The ball will come from top to bottom with the help of gravity at an angle of 10 degrees, which will be adjustable using this bevel screws, and after that we will note down the time. After that, one mechanical formula is there, that with the help of that mathematical formula we will calculate the dynamic viscosity of the solution. After this, another example, or you can say another advantage of this inclined falling ball viscometer is there, we can also calculate the kinematic viscosity of the solution. Like example, 40% sugar solution is having density of XYZ. After pouring, we can know the dynamic viscosity of the sugar solution with the help of falling ball viscometer, also the kinematic viscosity. With the help of these balls, we are having the metal balls and the glass balls, which is constant known net, and it is also having the diameter perfectly, which we can measure with the help of the vernier also, and it is having some ball constant that will help you in the calculation part of the mathematical formula. So, let's start with making the solution for the viscometer. First, what we have to do? We have to take the turn on the weighing scale. After turning on the weighing scale, I have put it one paper, plain paper, which is having some mass, make it 0. After making 0, I will take, as I have to make 40% sugar solution first. So, I will take 40 gram of sugar, and then that 40 gram of sugar we will pour, or you can say we will pour inside the 100 ml of water. So, I will make first 40 gram of sugar on the paper. After making 40 gram of sugar on the weighing scale, we will put in this beaker smoothly. After that, this is our 100 ml beaker. So, what we will do first, we will add not fully 100 ml of water, we will just add small amount of water, or 3 to 4 times of water inside the beaker for making dense liquid. So, I will pour it just this much, and after that we have to stir it. Constantly stir it until the sugar dissolved in the water. The sugar should be perfectly dissolved in the liquid. After that, we have to fill again water until 100 ml. After some time, it will dissolve inside the liquid. Now, we will pour some more water inside it and just stir it slowly. Now, fill it up to 100 ml. So, our volume is total 100 ml of liquid, but how to calculate the mass of the solution? So, for calculating the mass of the solution, I will take another glass. This is my another glass. After making on the top of this, we will make it zero. Now, pour this solution inside the beaker and our mass is coming 0.113 kg. It means 113 grams. So, total density formula is our mass upon volume. Our mass is 113 gram and our volume is 100 ml. So, the solution density of the solution will become 113 divided by 100, that is 1.13 gram per centimeter cube or milliliter. Centimeter cube is equivalent to milliliter. So, I will directly convert into the density 1.13 gram per centimeter cube. Now, this solution, 40% solution, I have already taken in my 40% solution is here. This 40% solution we have to pour inside the falling ball viscometer. Now, in this falling ball viscometer, as you will see, we have to just open this lead screw and we have to pour it inside this. I have already poured inside liquid the 40% solution. Now, I have already taken one glass ball which is inside this. Just simply you have to put glass ball inside it and cover it properly. Now, my glass ball is at the downside. So, in this falling ball viscometer inside glass, we are having the markings, ring markings, black color 1, 2, 3. I will name it as A, B, C. So, what it will do when we have to start the stopwatch and when we have to stop the stopwatch. At the time of the ball will come to ring A, we have to start the stopwatch, and at the ring C, the ball will touches, we have to stop the stopwatch. So, I will make it at again 10 degree and the ball is slowly it will come and I will start the stopwatch at ring A. I have started the stopwatch at ring A. The ball will going down smoothly inside the Newtonian fluid with the help of a gravity at an inclined angle of 10 degree. It reaches the ring B. Now, ring C is coming. When it touches ring C, we have to stop the time. I have stopped the time and it is coming 24.41 milliseconds. So, again what we have to do, we have to take the mean time, because sometimes what happens, some of the air bubbles will be inside the glass tube. So, what we will do, we will turn again at an angle of 10 degree and again we will calculate time and we will take the mean time. So, now the ball reaches at the bottom. Again, I will turn it at an angle of 10 degree and I will start the watch at 1. So, I have started the watch, ring A touches, it is going on, it is going down with the help of the gravity inside the Newtonian fluid at an angle of 10 degree. It reaches ring B. Now, our time is coming 24.15 milliseconds. So we have to calculate the average time. So 24.57 divided plus 24.15, which is coming around 24.3 seconds. So with the help of this glass inclined tube galvanometer, viscometer, and our stopwatch, and with the help of these balls, we have to calculate the dynamic viscosity. Now the dynamic viscosity formula we will take as per the given in the manual. After taking the data inside the data sheet, we will come to the sugar solution of 40%. Our density of the ball, that is 2.2 gram per centimeter cube, which is inside this glass tube. Our density of the solution already we have calculated previously, of the solution, that is around 1.13 gram per centimeter cube. Ball constant K, which is standard 0.09 megapascal second centimeter cube per gram second. And the falling time, which we have calculated by taking both mean in a 180 degree at an angle of 10 degree, coming 24.3 seconds. So the measuring temperature right now is at 30 degree Celsius ambient. Now the mathematical formula for calculating the dynamic viscosity of the solution is ball constant K into density of the ball, that is density of the ball minus density of the solution, multiply by the falling time, which will give you the dynamic viscosity in the megapascal second. So our ball constant is here 0.09 into our ball density, that is second number ball density, which is standard. All these ball densities are already given in the manual. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This all 6 balls constant and the density already given in the manual, and the ball constants are already given in the manual. So our right now ball 2 I am using for this experiment of 40% sugar solution. So right now my ball constant number 2 is 0.09. Density of the ball number 2, that is 2.2 gram per centimeter cube, minus our density of the solution, that is coming 1.13 gram per centimeter cube, and our falling time in seconds, that is 24.3. So let's calculate how much the dynamic viscosity is there. The 0.09 multiplied by 2.2 minus 1.13 into our falling time 24.3, which is coming around 2.34 megapascal second. So at the temperature of 30 degree Celsius, our sugar solution 40%, in which 40 gram sugar it added in 100 ml of water, it means 40 gram solution we have made for this falling ball viscometer, and with the ball number 2, that is having a constant of 0.09, and the density of the ball is 2.2, we have calculated the viscosity of our 40% sugar solution is dynamic viscosity 2.3 megapascal second. Now let's get calculate the kinematic viscosity. The kinematic viscosity is dynamic viscosity divided by density of the solution. So the density of the solution is our 1.13. So our kinematic viscosity is 2.34, just now we have calculated, divided by 1.13, that is our density of the solution. So it is coming around 2.07. So our kinematic viscosity is coming 2.07 millimeter square per second. So with the help of this data and with the help of this equipment, what we have calculated, the dynamic and kinematic viscosity of the sugar solution. So example, same way, if you are having any kind of a liquid, like example oil, vegetable oil, or kerosene, or petrol, or diesel, or the Newtonian fluids like sugar solution, glucose plus fructose solution, all this we have to make with the help of this weighing scale. I will make the solution. After making the solution, we have to calculate the density. After making the density, or after calculating the density, just pour it inside this glass tube. After pouring into the glass tube, as per the mathematical formula I have explained, we have to calculate the dynamic viscosity, and from there we have to calculate the kinematic viscosity. So this way we have completed the experiment for falling ball viscometer at 10 degree with the help of our sugar solutions and the auxiliary equipments. In falling ball viscometer model 29F, after completing the experiments, we have to see how to clean the equipment. Because this is a measuring equipment, we have to precisely handle it, and as is weighing around 50 to 60 kg, so we have to handle it accurately, and it is having a precise glass tube also, inside glass tube also. So how to clean it and how to again pour another liquid precisely, that we will see now. Now, first what we have to do, we have to remove this Newtonian fluid which we have taken for the experiment, that is 40% sugar solution, and we will remove it with the help of this beaker and this tool. So, we have to remove this glass tube. So, for removing this glass tube, we have to remove this lead screw. So, here is the lead screw. So, after removing this, we have to hold this glass tube and remove this. We have to remove these check nuts. So, after opening this check nut, we will remove this glass tube separately. Now, this glass tube is having a top part and the bottom part. For this, we have to open the bottom part for remove the liquid. So, I will open this base lead screw. And we have to remove this black cap. Very accurately. After removing this black cap, I will pour this liquid inside this beaker. Another amount of liquid is here because the ball is there. So, with the help of some piston object, we have to clean this glass tube. After that, I will just simply close this with the help of this black jack and lead screw. I will take open part for the top one. For this, we have to use this tool and open this. After just opening this, I have already removed the air from the upper top part. So, our ball is gone downside. So, no need to open this right now. When we will pour the new liquid, that time I will show you how to pour the liquid. Right now, we will just remove the ball number 2 from the glass tube. Again, I will open this one and after simply removing this, our ball number 2 is coming outside. Close this slowly and this ball number 2, you have to clean it and then you have to make it inside the box. Close this with the help of this lead screw. Now, for cleaning this glass tube, you have to open the top part. Remove this with the help of this tool. One inside jacket is there that you have to open with the help of this flat pen. So, as you can see, another inner thread jack is coming. This, you have to, after opening this, this black jack you have to remove. So, our glass tube is here. Now, how to pour the liquid? So, again same, this liquid you have to take. Like, I will take another same liquid, but if you want to take another 40% or 20% sugar solution, you can take, just take this liquid and simply pour. Inside the glass tube. We have to pour like that. There is no air bubble inside the glass tube. I will take ball number 1 right now for the another experiment. Simply just take this ball, pour it inside. After pour it inside, take this black jack. Slowly you have to fit inside this. After fitting this, the air will come outside from the top part. This is a lock pin. Attach the lock pin. Take the another inside thread jack. But before this, I have to open this first and attach this with the help of this again flat pin. Slowly, tightly, precisely you have to attach, because there is a glass tube inside it, and then attach the lock pin. After attaching the lock pin, I will take the lead screw. It is having a threading. So I have loaded the another ball with the 20% or 40% sugar solution. Now there is an air bubble inside it. So what we have to do, we have to pour some liquid inside this. Air bubble is inside this. So again we have to open this, because we have to remove that air bubble. For that we have to fill small amount of liquid. So I will take same solution. Again, I have to remove this, and now. So here with me, the same solution, 40%. I have to slowly open this. After opening this, I will simply just little bit pour this 40% liquid. Okay, the excess amount of liquid will come just inside of this jacket. As you can see, there is excess amount of solution is there, so it will directly come out of that air hole. After doing this, I will attach this lead screw. We have to tighten this jack pin with the help of this flat spanner, and first we will check there is no air bubble. So for that I will just, now as you can see there is no air bubble inside it, so we will lock perfectly from the top, and again check from the bottom also, it's perfectly closed. I'll take our base stand. Make it inside the hole. Connect the check nuts. 2 check nuts are there. Tight it with spanner. The another one you can tight it with your hand. And the last one, the bevel screw. So there is an inside threading also in the bevel screw. it should be tied. And now our ideal gas falling ball viscometer is ready for the another experiment. So this way you can maintain or you can fill another liquid or balls inside the falling ball viscometer.